On day one, I spawned into the glowing ancient forest as Fire Mario! Wahoo! I must have eaten the fire flower to get all this fire power! Also explains why I have really bad heartburn. I've only got 10 hearts, and they're all burning! But I was distracted from my heartburn by a loud buzzing noise. I looked up and saw a giant mosquito hovering above me.
Hey, you got 10 hearts, do ya? Bet there's a lot of blood in those hearts. And sucking blood just happens to be my specialty. The name's Mozzie. Mozzie Mosborn. Pleased to drink ya.
That pun doesn't even work. Drink doesn't rhyme with meat. Eat does.
Oh, I'll be doing the eating around here. One way or another, I'm getting your blood, plumber boy.
I didn't like the sound of that. Mosquitoes suck at the best of times. I turned and ran as quick as my little Mario legs would carry me until I couldn't even see Mozzie or hear his annoying buzzing. Phew, looks like I'm safe here.
Not so fast.
It was a creeper spiderling, and he looked really mean. I just can't catch a break today. Mamma mia. I wasn't strong enough to use my fire powers yet, so once again, I just booked it in the other direction. Wow, this world has a bug problem. Might be time for this plumber to play pest controller. On day two, I emerged from my hiding place in the glowing ancient forest. Wow, the plants look really weird and wild around here. I hope at least some of them are edible, or I'm gonna be in real trouble. I searched around, avoiding anything that looked poisonous, until I was lucky enough to find some delicious apples. Molto bene. It's like Ma always said, eat apples. I started breaking down the tree with my powerful Italian fist until I had a bunch of apples to enjoy and enough wood to build myself a wooden pickaxe. Wow, I'm wasted in plumbing. I should have been a carpenter. I mined up enough stone to make a stone sword and pickaxe. Then it was time to build myself a little Mario base. Soon enough, after a few hours of construction, I had a humble shack to call my own. It wasn't much, but it was mine. But some people don't respect personal property. People like the Creeper Spiderlings, one of whom was coming right towards my base.
Well, if it isn't the boss's favorite refreshment, he wanted me to either web you up or blow you up. And as a Creeper Spiderling, that's me specialties.
Wow, you're two things that never should have been combined. Plumbing is my specialty, but I double majored in kicking butt. With my stone sword, I took on that gnarly monster and defeated him before he had a chance to detonate my livelihood. That's why you don't mess with me, Mario. Woohoo! On day three, I was wandering through the fungal patch looking for some delicious mushrooms to add to a mushroom stew I was making back at my base. But there wasn't much room in the fungal patch, cause so much of it was being taken up by a big axolotl. Mind if I pick some mushrooms here, Mr. Big Axolotl?
Yeah, I have a name, and it's Krungus. Also, no, you can't pick mushrooms.
Fair enough. I'll respect your boundaries. Can you recommend anywhere else that I can search for mushrooms?
That's it, Buster. Nobody asked Krungus where to find mushrooms in this overworld. I'm gonna destroy you, just for asking.
The battle commenced. I had a sword now, but Krungus the Big Axolotl was still too big and too strong. There was no way I'd survive with Krungus among us. I just needed to make like an apple and leave. But the day wasn't a total wash. On the way out of the fungal patch, I ran into a friendly spider llama named Sal.
Hey, Zozo, how's it going, man? You're looking fire.
Oh my goodness, Sal, I haven't seen you since college. We've got a lot of catching up to do. Wanna come hang out at my base? I was thinking of doing some home reno, and I know you're a chartered architect.
Actually, I've taken a different career path. I switched my major to spider llama, but I'll still happily come with you, buddy boy.
Oh yeah! From day four to day five, I constructed a perfect spider llama den, just like one I'd see on the Discovery Channel once.
Wow, Zozo, this is amazing. You're a real king. If I've ever been in a spider llama den, it's here and now in this spider llama den.
Thank you, Sal. You always know just what to say.
I'm gonna get some shut-eye. We'll hang like Donkey Kong in the morning. Blada bing, baby.
Sal the spider llama went to bed after that, and just while I was staring at the sky and thinking about life, I heard the telltale legs of another creeper spiderling.
Hey, room for one more spider hybrid? I promise I won't take you to Mozzie. I'm chill. I swear.
Are you lying? Because if you are, you legally need to tell me if I ask.
Dang it! I was hoping you wouldn't ask. The truth is, I'm here to capture you or blow you up. One of the two.
I'm from Brooklyn, buddy. I'm immune to explosion damage. Let's tango. And we did tango. But the kind of tango you do with swords. And I led, which means I defeated him with my sword. Wow, what a victory. And it looks like he dropped something. It was an awesome Kyther blade. This is probably pretty powerful. I'll save this for a special occasion, rather than wasting it on these goji maka snackaroons. From day 6 to day 8, I was in the farther reaches of the glowing ancient forest, gathering materials. While I was out there, I happened upon a few sheep and was instantly charmed by their calm energy and witty remarks. You guys are all right. How about you come back to my base? I'll build you a paddock and everything. They followed me back to my base, where I built a fence around them. They had plenty of room to play, exercise, and contemplate life's biggest questions. But the biggest question I could think of as I returned to the forest was, when did Mozzie sneak up behind me? And why did he have such a sick battle axe?
Hey, Zozo! I got a riddle for you. What's worse than a mosquito without a battle axe?
I don't know, Mozzie, what?
Darn it! I was hoping you'd tell me. Anyway, my dad gave me this sick battle axe. I'm gonna chase you with it now.
I appreciate your honesty, Mozzie, but how about you don't do that, though?
You should know better than to try reasoning with me, Zozo. I'm unreasonable, and proud of it.
I ran away as he buzzed after me, hacking like a madman who drank too much full sugar soda. There was no way I could face him at my current power level. I just needed to get out of there. Lucky for me, everyone knows a Mario is faster than a bug, so I was able to escape. But I don't ever want to cut it that close again. Who knows what his dad will give him next time? From day 9 to day 10, I returned back to my base, feeling terrified, but relieved I still had all my blood in my body. I always thought a mosquito would just be annoying, but Mozzie is straight up terrifying. Lucky for me, I had my good pal Sal waiting for me at my base in the glowing ancient forest. He immediately ran over with some exciting news to give me.
Hey, Zozo! Don't be a bozo. You'll be happy to know-no. I've got cool stuff to show-show.
Why are you talking like that?
Yeah, I just thought it was funny. Come check out the statue I've been building for you.
Oh, a statue? Why didn't you say so earlier? I ran over to see the statue that Sal had started. It looked awesome. I couldn't quite tell what it was going to be yet, but it already looked incredible. Do you know what it is yet? If you can guess, give me a hint down in the comments. But it wasn't just a statue that Sal had built. He had also made a few other awesome base upgrades, including a pizza joint called Sal's Pizza, a storage room for all our gear, and a furnace for cooking pizzas and smelting metal. This base is just... chef's kiss. From day 11 to day 12, exhausted from all the work we'd done in the days before, I decided to sit around and relax with my favorite paizen, Sal the Spider Llama. Feels good to finally relax after these last few weeks. I'd be lying if I said this whole thing wasn't stressful.
You're telling me? I've had that mosquito and his minions all over me for months now. If I didn't have 8 legs, I don't think I would have escaped.
So Mozzie's been a problem for a while, huh? How exactly did this whole situation start? Giant mosquitoes don't just pop out of thin air, right?
Believe it or not, it was all down to bad plumbing.
What? Really?
Yeah, Perino. Bad pipes all over the overworld started bursting. And when they did, it made these big old pools of stagnant water. And you know what lives in pools of stagnant water? Mosquito larvae. And with giant pools, you get giant mosquitoes. Didn't take long for Mozzie to rule most of the mutant bugs in the overworld.
Wow, so a lack of a good plumber caused this whole problem. Then I guess we need a plumber like me to come and solve it.
Yeah, that's the attitude, Zozo.
From day 13 to day 15, I decided to return to the fungal patch, knowing I needed to take on the big axolotl before I had any hope of defeating Mozzie. There are burst pipes everywhere under the overworld. It must be causing a lot of underground moisture. Now I know where all this fungus is coming from. But my day soon went from fungus to crungus as I ran into crungus, the big axolotl.
If it isn't that sad little plumber. Come to pay your respects to the largest amphibian in the fungal patch? Or do you want to get beat down again?
Nobody's gonna beat me down, you big slimy bully. I'm a plumber. I'm here to help people. Sure, sometimes I show up late. Sure, sometimes I overcharge people. Okay, maybe I drink all the coffee and eat a bunch of cookies from the people I'm working for. But compared to you, I'm still the good guy. And with that rousing, inspirational speech, the battle was on. With my new confidence and new strength, I was able to turn the tables and defeat Krungus, the big axolotl. When I did, I gained enough XP to level up. I got bigger, stronger, went up to 30 hearts, became fierier, more Italian, and gained a new power, fire breath. Oh yeah, nobody's gonna stop me now. From day 16 to day 19, I decided that I needed some weapons. That's why I ventured down into the depths of a nearby mining cavern. Stone is fine, but metal is really where it's at. That's what I need to swat that nasty mosquito. Using my fire abilities to light the way, I soon found a healthy vein of iron ore hidden in the dark. This is exactly what I need. Let's go! Using my pickaxe, I dug up enough iron to make myself a new set of tools, then started making my way out of the cave. But on the way out, I ran into an angry fire guardian who didn't like people trespassing on his subterranean domain. I guess firepower solidarity isn't a thing around here. I couldn't use my fire breath against him, so instead, I pulled out my sword and battled as hard as I could until I was the only remaining fire being in the cavern. Let's get out of here before any other scary mobs show up. I went back to my base and used the furnace that Sal built to smelt the ore into some ingots. And with those ingots, I built myself a new iron sword and an iron pickaxe. Yeah, this is more like it. From day 20 to day 22, I was rudely woken up in the middle of the night by Sal the Spider Llama.
Hey, Zozo, you gotta wake up, man. Some bad stuff is going down out here.
Oh no, is the plumbing on the fritz again?
No plumbing, man, but we are in some deep doo-doo right now. Mozzie the Giant Mosquito is right outside. And let me tell you, buddy, he looks thirsty.
Oh, geez, I better go and take care of this. I got out of bed and ran out of the front of my base. Sure enough, there was Mozzie the Giant Mosquito floating in front of my base.
Hey, Zozo, it's me. I'm gonna suck your blood now. I bet with you being a Fire Mario and all, it's gonna be real spicy, like a cinnamon latte.
Not on your life, Mozzie. I'm not gonna let you drain me like a Capri Sun. You and your beastly bugs are never gonna take over the world.
I wouldn't be so sure about that, buddy boy. You ain't got no idea what I got planned. Bad stuff's gonna happen. And I know I'm being vague about it, but it's true. Anyway, let's fight.
I pulled out my iron sword and ran into battle. With my cold iron and my hot fire breath, I was able to hold my own this time, fighting off the diabolical parasite until he couldn't fight anymore.
Whoa, you really are a spicy meatball, Zozo. I'll pick this up another day, okay? I'ma go drain someone else.
And with that, he buzzed off. I was amazed to see how well I'd done in the fight. Maybe there was hope for me after all. From day 23 to day 26, I was wandering around the glowing ancient forest, as I usually do. It feels good to stretch my legs, especially after Sal broke the treadmill back at the base. While walking, I happened upon something amazing, a spiked shell armor piece. Normally, because I was Mario, I'd be concerned about a spiked shell, especially if I was driving. But something about this one just seemed right. If ever there was a Koopa inside there, someone had schlooped it out, so I decided I'd wear it for myself. Wow, not only is this comfy, it gives me knockback resistance, a thorns ability, and extra water breathing. But knockback resistance won't protect you from getting your mind blown, which is what'll happen if you search ZOZO for more of my amazing Minecraft adventures. Do it, I dare you. From day 27 to day 31, I was jumping around my Fire Mario base in the glowing ancient forest when Sal the Spider Llama scurried over to hang out with me and tell me about the statue.
Hey, Zozo, I've been clambering around putting blocks on the new statue, and it's a going so right, but it needs a little something from use.
Anything for a friend, Sal. You name it, and I'll move mountains to get you to the thing you need for the statue.
You're the best friend a Spider Llama could have, Zozo. You make me want to be a better guy. If you want to go find clay, I'll shower you with even more praise.
Wahoo! That sounds grandioso! I departed for the flowering ancient grove where I could find Sal's precious clay. I was searching around the area when I heard the skittering of spider legs behind me. Sal? Is that you, my friend?
No, it's a me, Creeper Spiderling.
Oh no, the horror! Not another one!
Yes, another one! I'm gonna make things very bad for you. Right now!
The Creeper Spiderling charged in, so I defended myself using my iron sword. I gave myself a little distance and unleashed my fire breath. The Creeper Spiderling was burned up in a great ball of fire. With the mob defeated, I was able to locate the clay and gather the amount that Sal requested. From day 32 to day 35, I was running along through the flowering ancient grove and finding skeletons left and right. There were just so many skeletons. I didn't know where they came from. Where do skeletons come from? A skeleton factory? Thankfully, the skeleton fighting didn't go on all day, and I was able to get back to my travels. As I continued along, I met a wind serpent who went by the name Walter.
I'm Walter.
Enchanted to meet you, Walter. My name is Fire Mario, but all my friends call me Zozo. You should call me that too, so you can be my friend.
You're Zozo. I'm Walter. I need help.
Will you help me?
Yes, Walter, I'll help you. What do you need?
Rescue my friend Walter the Wolfman from the Ender Creeper.
Your friend is named Walter too?
His name is my name too. Whenever we go out, people always shout, "There goes Walter the Wind Serpent and Walter the Wolfman." Now go save him.
From day 36 to day 39, I discovered the base of the Ender Creeper. It was way less cool and good than my base, but that made sense because I'd heard the Ender Creeper wasn't a cool or good guy. I'm a Mario on a mission. I've got to reunite the Walters and defeat the Ender Creeper who tried to tear them apart. I hopped onto the roof of the base and looked inside through a skylight. I could see Walter the Wolfman tied to a chair, looking really annoyed. Obviously, he was wolfnapped by the monstrous Ender Creeper. I stayed hidden as the Ender Creeper slowly creeped into the room. Why were these hybrid monsters always so horrifying?
There's no escape, Walter the Wolfman. That'll teach you to be friends with that Wind Serpent who has the same name.
You know, it really isn't that big of a deal that my name is Walter and I'm friends with someone named Walter.
Don't make me laugh. Of course it is. Your friendship would just confuse people, Walter. So I'm keeping you from ever seeing the other Walter again.
The Ender Creeper really is a creep. Telling other people who they can be friends with is not right. I'm going to use my fire breath to burn down his wooden walls. That'll teach him a lesson. From day 40 to day 43, I sprung into action, setting fire to the Ender Creeper's base. It's the end for you, Ender Creeper. Release Walter the Wolfman. Walter should be free to be friends with other Walters.
You maniac! You set my house on fire! I have to save my super boots. They're my most prized possession.
The Ender Creeper ran for a display pedestal that had a shiny new pair of super boots. For me! I'll be having those. I ran quickly over to the boots and equipped them. Now I could jump higher than ever before. Thanks for the boots, Ender Creeper. They fit me way better. I jumped down onto him and defeated the creepy Walter Thief. I untied the ropes on Walter Wolfman, setting him free. You're safe now, Walter. Thanks to Zozo, the Fire Mario.
You're a hero to Walters everywhere. I can't wait to see Walter again.
You can thank me later. Let's get out of here before this place burns down. We left the base and found Walter the Wind Serpent waiting for us outside. The Walters were together again, and everything was better. From day 44 to day 49, I returned to the base with the clay I'd gone to the Flowering Ancient Grove to find. The Walter quest had been such a big thing that I had almost forgotten the reason why I'd been exploring in the first place. I dropped off the clay with Sal so that he could continue to work on the statue.
Bada bing! That's the right stuff! You sure took your sweet time, but the statue is gonna be even sweeter!
I'll be looking forward to it! For now, I think I'll do some renovating on my own. I gathered some stone and iron and constructed a giant wall around the entire perimeter of the base. I built it high to make it more difficult for enemy mobs to break in and ruin my day. When I was done, I admired the progress that Sal the Spider Llama had made on the statue. It was coming along now, and the clay was now part of the charm. From day 50 to day 53, I heard buzzing in the wind and knew that Mozzie had come back to get me. He flew straight over the big strong wall that I had built the other day and called me out like he was a knight making a challenge. An annoying knight, that is. It was actually a mosquito.
Hey, Zozo! The thing about walls is they can only keep out mobs that don't fly or climb.
I know the wall didn't help at all. I can see that with my Fire Mario eyes, but you're not helping by pointing that out.
Hold on a second. I wasn't listening. Let me say that other thing I was saying again. Or climb!
Mozzie signaled to his minions, a small army of Creeper Spiderlings that climbed over the wall. Oh no, that's what he meant!
Yeah, how about you deal with them? Cause I'm not gonna be here. I got an errand to run, and I'm taking Sal with me.
Mozzie flew away, stealing away Sal the Spider Llama, and leaving me to battle the Creeper Spiderlings. I attacked a bunch of them with my fire breath, and then hacked the others down with my iron sword. The battle was over shortly, and the epic win made me power up into Super Fire Mario. My number of hearts was now 50, and I could throw actual fireballs now. Blop, blop, kapow! From day 54 to day 57, I made the wall around the base taller, because if I couldn't keep out the Creeper Spiderlings, I could at least tire them out by forcing them to climb more before they made it in. This won't do anything about Mozzie, though. It's a good thing that he was busy with his errand the other day, but I might not be so lucky next time. Later on, I went to the Flowering Ancient Grove in order to visit my two favorite Walters. Walter the Wolfman was staying with his family when I was there, so I didn't see him, but Walter the Wind Serpent was there.
Thanks again for saving Walter the Wolfman. He would have thanked you himself, but he wanted to see his family because they didn't know where he was during the kidnapping by Ender Creeper. He'll be back here soon.
Walter, what should I do about Mozzie? He's been buzzing around my base and threatening me like always. Plus, he took Cell the Spider Llama away. I also care about that.
Oh, sure. We'll talk about your troubles. The thing about Mozzie Mossborn, he's extremely annoying. And you can't beat that just by ignoring him. He wants to drain you like a mosquito, and he'll do any trick it takes to get there. You must fight back.
I get it now. I can build all the walls I want, but if I don't stand up for myself, all in all, I'm just another brick in the wall.
Go to Ethereal Island. There you will find your friend.
From day 58 to day 62, I went mining for diamonds down in the caverns below my base. There were a lot of gas floating around, but with my mad fireball throwing skills, they weren't much trouble at all. Blap, 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 blap. Go away, Ender gas! With the mobs taken care of, I mined to my heart's content. There were diamonds aplenty, so I gathered them and crafted a diamond pickaxe and a diamond sword. How do you like me now? From day 63 to day 66, I was bothered by the fact that Sal wasn't working on the statue anymore. But then I remembered that he was probably still in the terribly annoying clutches of Mozzie. I guess the statue isn't really worth worrying about compared to my missing best friend. Sal never came back from that errand that Mozzie took him along for. I should go looking for him. And if you want to look for more Zozo videos and find them easier than ever, you should subscribe to the channel and ring the bell so that you will be notified of all my videos whenever they're new. Now to find my good friend Sal the Spider Llama. From day 67 to day 70, I did as Walter the Wind Serpent said and journeyed to the Ethereal Island through an end portal. It was a mysterious and strange biome beyond the realm of imagination, just like Brooklyn. I battled the Creeper Spiderlings nonstop until they left me alone. Those guys had been around more than enough at this point. At one point, I stopped fighting and instead stopped to actually speak to some of the remaining Creeper Spiderlings. Okay, just humor me for a second before we start trying to destroy each other. I've survived this long. Don't I at least deserve that?
All right, we'll listen, but then we're totally gonna destroy you.
Why do you actually work for that Mozzie guy? He's really weird and annoying, and you don't seem to actually get anything out of this.
We're all bugs, and bugs have gotta stick together.
But you're not actually the same kind of bug. He's a mosquito with 6 legs. That means he's an insect, and you're Creeper Spiderlings with 8 legs. That means you're all arachnids. You don't actually have that much in common.
Oh, well, in that case, I don't know why we're here at all. Let's get out of here, boys.
And with that, all the Creeper Spiderlings left, and I continued deeper into the base. From day 71 to day 74, I ran deeper into the base, searching anywhere I could for my best buddy, Sal. Come on, Sal, you've got to be around here somewhere.
Did somebody say Krungus?
Suddenly, Krungus, the infamous big axolotl, came from behind the tree. Krungus? No, I didn't say that, because I thought I defeated you.
Oh, you big dum-dum. It takes more than death to stop me, for I am Zombie Krungus. Big, big Krungus! Big Krungus! Big Krungus!
Once he'd finished his weird war cry, he attacked me, and we started battling once again. He was strong, probably even stronger than the last time we fought, but I'd gotten stronger too. I dashed him with my sword and blasted fireball after fireball at him, slowly watching his evil zombie powers drain away. With one more decisive blast, he'd been destroyed once and for all. Can't believe I've defeated that guy twice. It's gotta be really embarrassing to be Krungus right now. As I continued my search, I found a chest in a desolate old hallway that contained some awesome diamond armor that I immediately equipped. Wow, Mozzie should really be a lot more careful about what he just leaves around. From day 75 to day 78, I heard a familiar voice yelling in the distance.
Hey, I'm yelping here.
That sounds like Sal. I ran deeper in until I found Sal trapped inside a distant cage in the deep dark bowels of Mozzie's base.
Zozo, buddy, you came to save me.
Shh, be careful. I need to break you out of here before Mozzie notices. I used my diamond pickaxe to break down the cage and free Sal. I told him to run back as quickly as he could and not stop for any reason, so he did. That's when I could sense something rising behind me and turned to see Mozzie floating there behind me.
I knew life bait would work. Time to drink me some Mario.
Drink this, Mozzie. I blasted a fireball at his face, and while he was distracted, I ran for it, all the way out of his lair. From day 79 to day 84, alone in his evil lair, Mozzie the Mosquito was evolving.
What that doofazoid Zozo doesn't know is that all this time, I've only just been a mosquito nymph. I can get so much stronger, so much more dangerous. All this time, I've been holding back. But my dad gave me this golden apple. Now, I can finally be me!
Mozzie Mosborn ate the golden apple and began to grow, getting bigger, stronger, and more dangerous than ever. He could drain an unlucky victim in a single slurp.
You're mine, Zozo. I'ma get you, and I'ma drink you up.
He was silent for a second after that.
Man, it would have been so much cooler if Zozo was here to hear that.
From day 85 to day 89, I returned back to my base with my bestest bud in the whole wide world, Sal the Spider Llama.
Zozo, you're the best. You saved me back there. I'm never, ever gonna forget what you did for me. I was worried that I'd never be found again, trapped in the depths of that nasty mosquito's lair.
Don't even talk like that, Sal. Of course I'd come and save you. I'd never even think about abandoning you in a place like that. You're my best friend.
And hey, me being trapped in there wasn't totally wasted time. While I was bored and trapped in there, I decided to work on a new recipe for an extra spicy pizza sauce. But in the process, I accidentally created a fire aspect enchantment that you can apply to your diamond sword. I also found this mysterious note in my prison cell.
Oh, that's perfect. It's like the discovery of penicillin, but way more useful to me personally. Also, I'll check this note out later. Let me apply the enchantment first. I applied the fire aspect enchantment to my sword, massively increasing its deadly firepower, just like me, Mario, Zozo. Just like a me! Fire Mario Zozo! Sal, you're the best pal!
Oh, stop it, man! You're gonna make me cry!
From day 90 to day 94, I traveled to the mini base of the Ender Creeper out in the flowering ancient forest, curious about who could have left that mysterious note. When I arrived, I was shocked to see one of the Creeper Spiderlings waiting for me. Oh no, I suppose you lured me out here to fight on behalf of your boss, right?
You may think so, but no. You really changed our whole outlet when you taught us about all the differences between insects and arachnids. We're going our own way now, pursuing our own dreams. And we have you to thank for that, seeing as you opened our eyes.
Oh, well, I'm actually really glad to hear that. Was there any reason you brought me out here, or just to thank me?
We mainly just wanted to thank you, but as a token of our thanks, I snuck out this potion of power from one of the boss's secret chests. Here. Have it. Save it for the right moment.
He passed me the potion of power, and I immediately added it to my inventory. I think this is gonna come in real handy when I finally battle your former boss for the last time. Thank you for your kindness, Creeper Spiderling, and good luck with the rest of your lives.
And good luck to you too, Zozo. No offense, but you're probably gonna need it.
From day 95 to day 97, while sitting around at my base, training for my final battle with Mozzie, I got an unexpected guest, Walter the Wind Serpent. Hey, Walter! How are you and Walter?
I'm doing well, and so is Walter. Thank you for asking. Walter and I have actually been working on something for you. A set of netherite armor to supplement your wardrobe. While you're wearing this, it's gonna be really hard for that nasty sucker to suck your blood.
He gave me the netherite armor pieces, and I immediately equipped them. They were durable, but not too heavy. These will be the perfect armor to take into the final battle. Thank you, Walter. And please, thank Walter for me when you see him again.
Will do, Zozo. Good luck on your battle. Walter and I will be rooting for you.
On day 98, I left the glowing ancient forest once and for all, ready to take on Mozzie Mosborn and show him that when you mess with Fire Mario Zozo, you get burned. But I'm not just Fire Mario. I can be anyone you want me to be. And who would you like me to be next? Let me know down in the comments. I love reading them all. After walking for half a day, I finally got to a working end portal I went through last time. A straight shot to the ethereal island where Mozzie and his gross, nasty friends hung out. Now or never, as the great man himself said, let's go! And so, I hopped right in. On day 99, I went straight back to Mozzie's base. Now that I knew my way around, it was a lot easier to make my way straight to his inner sanctum. He was hovering right over a dugout pool of water where more little mosquito larvae were probably growing.
Zozo, who said you could come in here, man? This is my private space, my mosey bro pad. I feel like violated in junk. I thought we were friends.
We're not friends at all. We're literally arch enemies.
Oh, yeah. Duh. Sorry, that slipped my mind. So, I guess you're here to fight until one of us is just a pile of XP?
Yeah, that was the plan. How about we get on with it? Your buzzing is really, really starting to get on my nerves. I took my potion of power and leveled up, becoming the final Fire Mario. Bigger, stronger, and the most Italian I've ever been. With 100 hearts and my final new ability, Dragon Fireball Attack. Time to fry this freaky fly. Mosey and I flew into battle. Well, he flew. I used my super boots to jump. Mozzie was tough, but this time I had the power to back myself up. First, I slashed at him with my awesome fire aspect sword, throwing him off with my speed and strength. But I was just getting started. Dragon Fireball after Dragon Fireball bombarded the diabolical mosquito, blasting and burning through every single one of his defenses. In the end, I came out on top, blasting every last one of the monstrous mosquito's hearts away. In the end, Mozzie was gone, and only I remained. Finally, sweet, sweet silence. Mamma mia. On day 100, with Mozzie Mosborn finally and deservedly swatted, I left the Ethereal Islands and returned to my base in the glowing ancient forest. Sal the Spider Llama, my oldest friend, was so happy to see me.
Hey, Zozo, my good fella. You did it. I couldn't be more proud of you. Sal's gonna cook up a big spicy pizza just for you. I also managed to finish the statue while you were gone. Check it out.
You're the best of them, Sal. A giant mushroom. I love it. Sal left to go and make the pizza when Walter the Wind Serpent slithered over.
You did it, Zozo. What a man, what a man, what a man, what a mighty good man. Another Walter would be here too, but he's at work. You're a winner, Zozo. Anything you want to say?
Only one word, Walter. Woohoo!